when it comes to a question of change in life, when it comes to a question of a crisis in life, they get the answer from Vivekananda. There is some power in those pages of the works of Vivekananda, where when we have problems, we read Vivekananda, we get an answer. When we have a crisis, we read Vivekananda, we get strength. When we want spirituality, read Vivekananda and we get a breakthrough, an insight. There is a power, actual spiritual power, shining through those pages. A small example. One of the top executives of a multinational corporation, Johnson & Johnson, in fact, he told me that he used to read Vivekananda. But he was not spiritual in the so-called sense of going to a temple or meditating, just used to read Vivekananda once in a while. And he got a job in a top liquor company. And he was doing very well. One day in the evening, he was sitting quietly with a book of Vivekananda's in his hands and reading. Suddenly he was struck by this thought. What is the purpose of my life now? Working day and night for this liquor company. So he says, I can see clearly the purpose of my life is to get as many people drunk as much as possible. Then he said, truly speaking, I can either go on reading Vivekananda and give up this job, or I can do this job but I have to give up reading Vivekananda. And I have to take a decision. And he says, yet Swami, I don't want to become a Swami, I don't want to give up everything, and I want to go on leading this life. But what can I do? So what he did finally was he dropped that job, to the horror of many of his friends, and he took up a job in a company which was producing this products for babies, for children. So it's a company where he doesn't clash with his conscience. So you see how reading Vivekananda leads him to make a choice.